that linebacker. He's going to see where he is. So in this particular configuration, he's kind of in this A gap area, what we call the A gap, A B C D outside.
He'd be the right linebacker, though.
Yeah, in that situation. So that's him. So we know as a quarterback, this safety is going to fill, right? Somebody has to take this spot right here. So what we know is we're going to get rotation to the front side. So the quarterbacks know that pre-snap. So now the quarterback has to read this guy and make a determination. Is it a seven-man box or is it still a six-man box? If it stays a six-man box, right, six guys, four down linemen, two linebackers, then it becomes a give. Quarterback will give
hat
it all
hat.
Just hat for hat and let's go. If the safety's coming out of the sky, we call that a six-and-a-half-man box, still a give, right? Because now what we're asking the tight end to do is basically, you know, a sift technique. He's either going to stay on or he may work up and block that safety. Most dangerous on the back side, okay, right there. So the other part of this now is when it's a true seven-man configuration, okay? So now we're in this situation right here, okay? Boom. Now let's say this safety's all the way down in the box, okay? So this safety's now in the middle of the field, right? And it becomes a true seven-man box. Now we have the numbers we want to take advantage of the throw. And this is where the typical bubble slant. And now we're gonna feel that defender right there from a quarterback's perspective, okay? And maybe even, you know, if he settles and they play zone, we'll throw it, right? If he attacks right here, then we're gonna throw the slant in behind. And part of the, you know, to play receiver in our system is you gotta be able to run a slant, particularly versus press, bump and run coverage.